First, though, news for every parent whose child has one of those small home computers or who uses one at school. As TVI's reporter Brian Gould has been finding out, they're not only the way into the technological world of tomorrow, some of the brightest youngsters, from the north of the country to the south, are turning them into a way to make money. We've called his report The Teenage Tycoons.
Three Northumberland schoolboys. They have turned their classroom computer lessons into money-spinning bestsellers.
That's basically because
David Edwards receives his first big check, all part of the huge rewards open to the computer whiz kids. More than 1 million British homes now have a microcomputer. The British firm of Sinclair made the breakthrough, and the British now have more home computers than anywhere else in the world. Most of the users are youngsters, taking to the computer as naturally as adults now use the telephone. Sales of microcomputers will double this year. And just as important, the youngsters will buy millions of pounds worth of software as well.
Software is another word for the programs or series of instructions which make the computer work. Now with me is Shelton Frey, who's just turned 11, I think, Shelton. Could you do something for me on the computer? Let's say make it draw a red square.
Yes, I can.
And you're giving the computer, what, half a dozen instructions, and up comes the red square.
But to write a whole computer game would need hundreds of such instructions, all painstakingly typed in one by one.
And it's for that reason that most people who don't have the time or the skill prefer to buy ready-made programs, which take the form of audio cassettes, which are loaded into cassette players, which are then played to the computer. Shelton, would you be able, for example, to program me into the computer?
Yes, yes, as a little man.
You could do that?
Yes.
Computer software today is for intellectually talented young people what the rock business was a few years ago. And yes, there'll always be the publisher, the producer, and the distributor who will seek to make money out of the business. But the talent can also get fabulously rich, even though they're young.
The path to riches can start wherever youngsters have access to a computer, and that's often in the classroom. In Northumberland, at the Prideaux County High School, three sixth formers head a computer revolution which has swept the school.
They do this at lunch times, after school, even before school, in fact. We find that the computers are running, you know, from early morning until late evening, and they're doing all sorts of work related to computers, and the three boys are part of that sort of setup within the school situation.
Geoffrey, Stephen and David write computer games and market them under their own JSD software label.
You see, that's where the frog's being printed on.
Oh, yeah. So you need colour 129?
Yeah. So we should... Yeah, let's try putting a colour 129 in there. See what effect it has. Yeah. So that was obviously set back.
To get it right requires a prodigious attention to detail.
Yeah, position. We'll check that later. I think the problem was we forgot the semicolon off. So it was scrolling up as it was progressing. So I'll try taking that off and see what...
But the results are worth it. A game which the boys claim is better than those previously available, and a product for which local shops have already paid them.
We've had the Orc in for about 2 weeks now. It's selling pretty well. The best thing about it is its graphics, its sound and its colour. Unfortunately, there's no software out at the moment for it.
Well, that's the main reason why we're buying this Orc. Because since it's...
Their first task is to get to know everything about how the new home computer works. Now they'll spend as much time as they can spare from their A-levels writing the programs which they hope the users will buy.
It's so that we get into the software market first. Since it's a brand new computer, there's no software around. And since we're into writing software programs, then we should be able to get there first and write the programs.
How seriously do you take it? Is it just a hobby, or do you really expect to make some real money?
Well, we feel that with some more retail outlets, it could really take off now. We'll have to put it on ice somewhat through university, but we intend to carry it on in a small way until after university. And after that, the sky's the limit.
Brian Gould with the Teenage Tycoons.